Hi. I received the results from my DNA genealogy test. It was a bit of a surprise. I thought it wouldn't be ready for another 3 weeks. They said, please give 4 to 6 weeks or longer. And then there was the email. Boom. Your DNA test results are ready. Well, I was so nervous that I had to cover my eyes and hold my breath and then look. The first was a bit disappointing because, like many red-blooded Americans, I've always wanted to be part Indian. Well, 0% Native American. 0% from Asia. 0% from Africa. 1% from the Caucasian regions around the Caucasian Sea. 1% from the Middle East. 98% from Europe. And of the 98% from Europe, 2% is Jewish. 4% is from the Iberian Peninsula, that is Spain and Portugal. 1% is from Italy and Greece. 11% is from Western Europe, which would include the German ancestors I already know about. 16% is from Scandinavia, which probably came into Europe and into Great Britain with the Vikings. 22% is from Ireland. And 42% is from Britain, which includes Wales and Scotland and England. Now, none of this is very surprising because I have traced back most of my genealogy to the 1500s. Though I know the individuals, in fact, who came from Ireland and Scotland and England and Wales and Germany. And we have had stories in the family. My grandmother used to say that she thought she was Jewish. Well, maybe she was. Maybe 4%, maybe 6%. They say 2%. However, I was, as I say, disappointed to find out that the family story that my grandfather might have been an Indian, those stories at least are probably not true. 0% Native American, 0%. Asia, 0% Africa. I'd always wanted there to be some kind of color in there, but yeah. Of course, the margin of error, I think, is bigger than 1%, so some of these things could be within the margin of error. Anything that's less than 2% definitely is within the margin of error, I think. Still, it's interesting. In my case, however, not very surprising because, as I say, I've got pretty much all the lines traced back, almost all of them, to 1790, 1760, and most of them to the 1600s, and some of them back even further. It's a fascinating subject, genealogy. I find myself getting bogged down, however, because now I've pushed it so far back with the help of my beloved late cousin, who did an enormous amount of work. She did 1,000 times more work than I have. But one or two things I could help her out, whereas she could only help me out with 98 out of 100 things. Excuse me, I've still got this cold. Summer cold is a different animal. So that's my news is. Now we're gonna. My mom's agreed to have the DNA test done for her, so we're going to get a double check because it was her father that the story was. It might have been an Indian. But you know, these stories, they get started and pretty soon they're off and running far into the distance.